starting off a new fiscal year here, the superintendent, I'd like to thank you for your best of luck to you. We don't have any public comments or anybody signed in, so we'll just go straight to administrative items. Have a motion, please. Mr. Baker? Thank you, Mr. Kerr.
It's been a past practice, my experience as assistant superintendent, that the superintendent has read each and every document to the board. Just want to ask you, want to continue in that same manner, or would you rather than just ask me to make questions regarding those items? Because I've seen that a lot of times.
Well, I don't ever do that, so it's better. I think reading is fine, I don't know what you need to do, you can make sure a lot of things, but just be just that.
Item A, it's 2015-16, board meeting schedule. Item B, contract recent to provide audiology services for the 2015-2016 school year, according to the terms of the contract. Item C is a contract recent to provide services of a food service director for the 2015-2016 school year, according to the terms of the contract. Item D, contract recent to provide services of Joe Carson for energy management programs for the 2015-2016 school year, according to the terms of the contract. Item E, a memorandum of understanding with recent to Leslie K. Tyree provide general legal services for the 2015-2016 school year, according to the terms of the MOU. Item F, an agreement with Applied Behavioral Learning Center to provide applied behavioral analysis services for reserve students for the 2015-2016 school year, according to the terms of the agreement. And lastly, item G, agreement with Developmental Therapy Center Incorporated to provide extended school year special education services to students July 1st through the 30th, 2015, according to the terms of the agreement.
Okay, does anyone have any questions or comments about the administrative items?
I have a comment, since we don't get charged for that CSO behavior. Any applied behavior, they charge an awful lot for travel.
Yep.
$69 an hour. Must be a good deal.
I'm just curious about the same thing, that there's a cap of 100 hours on the number of hours of service they can provide. Is there likewise a cap on the number of hours of travel, or does the 100 hours include, say, 60 hours of work and 40 hours of travel? But for budgeting purposes, you can estimate $6,900 for 100 hours maximum, but how do you estimate the number of hours of travel time?
Well, I see what you're saying. I'll have to get with Mr. Bennett and ask him.
And are most of these referrals, most of these referrals, do we send the student to their facility, or they come to the student?
They come to us, they visit us.
Well, that's a huge profit center, that's $69 an hour travel. Are we also paying mileage?
I believe so.
2 years ago, I paid $67 an hour for the therapist, and I said mileage to get there, but I didn't pay any travel time. But I mean, that may be more than that, or I'm not sure.
In the legal industry, you don't get this anymore, this stopped about 10 years ago. So.
Probably very subjective.
Do we want to table this one until I get some additional information this time?
I don't know how we would budget for this, as this is written here. I mean, it's open-ended on how many hours of travel we can incur.
Keep in mind, this is just for the summer, this is for 1 month. They probably already started for the extended school year.
It's July 1, 2016, so it's over.
No, it's July 1 through 30. You're talking about developmental therapy?
No, compliance services agreement. Of Applied Behavioral Learning Center.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Well, yeah, that is what the school is. And that's most of it. That IEP is just a center.
Kind of strike that.
Do I have anything else?
Just a note that our board meeting schedule will be preferred by being in the first block.
If it completes the work schedule on top.
I guess it's still under completion of that question, the presentations are that, last meeting, but it's gonna be all school reports for the plan, so it's making transportation.
Okay, no more questions, then we can have a vote on the district, I said it all, yes.
Yes.
Finance section, we have a motion, please.
Second.
Greg makes a motion, Carl seconds.
Okay, item A, scheduled invoice is totaling $147,854.23. And the invoices are available for public review in the county office. And that should be the end of fiscal year 15 expenditures.
Got it.
Yeah, checks, that's the end of the checks.
Okay, anything else, I have anything else to find out. Okay, all the things about the finance items.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.